Hey guys, welcome to Samurai Warriors 4 Empires. I'm not sure how well this is gonna go, so I'm kinda just gonna go with it and attempt. Because it works differently to a normal thing, to a normal one. So I did try this before. I tried the Battle of Okazama, just because I wanted to know how it worked, so it wasn't like a complete thing. We're not gonna do that one though. We're gonna do one of these ones. Jesus. So the incident at Honnoji. Oda is still on the battlefield there. You can see his flag in the middle. And if he's not on the, he's not there then. So we will. Let's go with the incident at Honnoji time. Normal difficulty is fine. Data reporting on. Determine whether or not Cassie has a lot of potential districts. I don't suppose that really matters. Custom characters. Yeah, why not? Let's leave our custom characters on. Female characters. This I'm not sure why is even an option. Yes, of course allow female characters. Officer deaths on. Determine whether or not officers can be executed. Hell yeah, leave it on. Okay. We are good to go. Now, these are our recommended. We recommended to be the Akechi clan, which I suppose is the who took over from Oda, because Oda's now kaput. He's now deaded. Well, there's this clan, the Hashimi, which is the thing is, these guys are right in the middle, right? Which I'm not a big fan of. These guys. Fuck those guys, we had no freaking way. The Sanada clan, that could be a good one, but again, we're over here in the middle of the area. But ideally, I want to be like up here, you know, so we can just like expand outwards. So, that could be a good one. The Dante, we can get the Dante clan and then kind of just like take the two areas behind us and then take this one, and then we've got a good structure to spread out from, I guess. Like these guys. These guys would be ideally. See how they've got their leader back in this territory? Because if we take that territory with the leader, then we get all the territories. Right? So, like, for example, he's in there, right? So, if. As Hideyoshi, thank you very much, that's a good check. As Hideyoshi, if we, like, went in here and killed off if we killed Akechi, we would take all of their areas, right? So, like, maybe, so that's why I feel like getting over here would be good, being the Dante clan, then we could take these guys and push our way out. So I feel that's probably the best way to do it. So we will be a recommended, and we will be this recommended guys over here. What is this fucking clan? Yeah, it seems like a fucking random clan. There's the Triforce dudes, the Hojos. Alright, let's be the date. The dates. Yep. Start the game? Yes, please. Oh no, wait, we didn't put my guy in. Bugger. Wait. Stop it, what are you looking at? Hello? Maybe we can recruit him. Okay, so select an officer to appoint as a strategist. So we need to look down here and see who has the best strategy. It's looking like this guy. He's got a good amount of everything. Okay, so we'll have that guy up there as our strategist. Now we need to select all these guys down here. So who has the best development? The best development appears to be these two. So there's one, and there's our other one. And a point. Yep. Now military, that's probably going to be... well actually, hang on, let's put this guy over here. Let's put this guy over here. And then personal, let's put... let's put you. And then, also in military, we'll put Dante. In development, we will put that guy. Oh no, wait, that guy was that guy there. Oops, I made a mistake. Put that guy in development, and then this guy in personal. Wait. Oh shit, I can't remember which one I put in. That fucking thing. Oh, shit. No! That guy. That guy. Damn it. That guy. There we go. That was so difficult. Okay. So our fame and strategy is actually quite low. However, everything else is quite good. So I'm okay with that for now. Again, I'm not like an expert on this, so... We get a bunch of stuff, okay. Which territory should we attend attention to? Okay, so then we get to pick a target, right? We get to pick a target. Because we want everything. We want the whole land. So we want, but we need to pick a target. Recommended this one. I would agree, actually, because this is where we want to put... Or a castle is there. So, look at the castle. Yeah, sure, we'll have that one. And that's where we'll keep everything, basically. So we'll keep our lord. Okay, I should do a bidding. Right, now we get to pick some policies. Right, so we get to listen, raise your fame. And these guys have got acquire formations. These guys have got employ an officer. Now, actually, that's a good point. If you go to this guy, we can select directly like what we want. So employ. I'm going to wonder if my guy is in here. He doesn't appear to be. Kita is, though. I don't know who Kita is. But there doesn't seem to be my guy seems to be there. I guess we'll just see when he comes along, I guess. Even though I was planning on having him as a part of our game. Okay, you know what? Hang on. Give me one second. Okay, hi, welcome back. So basically, I just I reran it and actually added the guy that I was gonna add. So there he is, the Cowlick Samurai. I don't know if people remember. I don't know if people remember him. But so request that has an interaction with people, and that will increase stuff. Basic tactic time. And acquire formation serpent. Increase rice fields. And if you click on him and seek his advice, he gives us like one of each. Like, oh, you can do this one and you can do this one together. So we're actually going to do that. I like that. We'll raise the rice fields by 55 and we'll acquire formation. So that's pretty good. There we go, we've got a much bigger rice field. We acquired the Serpent Formation. Right, next, we can now go into a battle phase. Where this is where we get to invade if we want. Basically, he has 6,300. His 6,300 facilities, he has a stable by the looks of things. Four officers. So he's not got a whole lot. He's pretty shitty. Honest. So we will invade him. We will put me in there because that's who we are. We will also go with Smoothie Dante. We'll go with everyone basically but our leader. That's my strategy. And this, our troop strength is 10,000. Now, troop strength is directly translated into your morale. Okay? I'll explain that once I have a visual aid. He's just sleeping. The battle begins. There's a path to the view. Everybody give it everything you got. Meanwhile, they were like, whoa, that's so inspirational. Yeah, it's like six dudes, but at least our dude is there. Or is he, so it directly relates to your morale. That you would, what you consider as morale. So because we have more men, we have a higher morale thing. That lowers their health, that lowers their attack. Pretty much lowers everything that they've got. Which is very good for us. Okay. So I changed my guy's thing. We can alter his outfit whenever we like. I don't think there's many other outfits that are really good, to be honest. All the outfits were kind of shit. If I'm honest. We've gone the wrong way. We've gone the wrong way. Come on, men. Back this way. Ah, here we go. So now we need to attack. And because we have such a higher morale, we have much more thing, which means we will lose less men because we have higher attacks, we have higher health, we have higher everything because of the morale system, right? So just like the samurai warriors you already know, except from it's directly related to the troop morale. So this will make taking this area easier, but because we're inside this area, their morale will be higher. See, on the map, again, just like it usually would be, you've got little pink areas, which is more morale. Although there's no bannerman in this game. Which, at least I've not found any bannerman as of yet. There could be bannerman at some point, I'm sure. My PlayStation is losing its shit. Ridiculous. Now, the more points you can take out, the more points... The more, like, the directly the more points you'll get. But you can perform some like little tricks if you're a bit sneaky. So we'll take this one. We'll take this one and we'll take that one over there. See, and then I'll try and explain what I mean. So we've actually had to expend resources to attack here. We've actually had to expend resources on getting everything how we want it to be, basically. And like how long you get in the battle also directly relates to how much money you spend and how much resources you expend by attacking this environment. Sometimes it's best to wait if they get attacked and stuff like that. Sometimes it's best to wait like that. But that's like obviously depending on your direct strategy. Right, so we need to take out a bunch of these men. See, they've got a morale buff and they're like a lot more HP. Now we could have attacked with the serpent thing, which would have obviously given us more help, but that's fine. See, everyone's at three, so let's, oops, not all defend, I want them all to charge. There's no need at all right now to defend, because everybody is just weak. Well, our basic goal is to cut off that main thing with the actual dude in it from everywhere else. So everywhere, all these like little supply points, we want to chop everything off. So we will go chop this one off right now, and they're all attacking through that way. Now you can't tell them to do this, but for example, we could do this. If we attack that very top left one, because there's no lines going to that red one, we would gain it because there's two blues from both sides. So we would automatically take control of them because we've cut it off, right? But they're just fucking charging through it and destroying it. There's a guy coming down here. Make sure we take out Nobukaki, whatever your name is. I do very apologize for butchering it, but I can't really help that. See how many men they're just like constantly losing where we've not lost any because of the massive morale difference. So from what I can tell, it's always best to go in with like as much as possible. But I didn't do very well on my first like attempt. I attempted the other battle, didn't I, like I said earlier. I actually didn't clear it. I ended up deleting it and I said like, oh, I'll try again at a later date, basically. Right, now they have no morale left. There's the boss. Just throw right in and just take him out. I used Masamori Dante to, Masamori Dante? No, I didn't use that. I used, Magarichi as, our fighting style because we love him so much. Okay, so we took him down. We steal his horse as well. Chestnut, is that you? If for a guy with stables, he didn't have any horses. Every squad got some EXP. We became a lieutenant. First, that'll be selected in the archives. Banners. There. Okay, so we took that area. Victory is ours. Fame is increased by 30. Erase the pages of history. Right. Now, these are the guys that we just beat the shit out of, basically. So we could either employ the. Oops, sorry. we can either employ, release, or execute them. So we can employ them, and he's like, very good. Okay, we got an extra soldier, and an extra set of men. There we go. Employ, very well. He's happy to employ us. And they're the only ones that made it back alive, basically. So there are two areas here. We will move him back, him back, him back. We'll basically move all these dudes back. And then in that area... Oh, no, wait. No. Because that's their castle there, isn't it? Right. Okay, so we'll actually move... Not you guys. But we will move them and... The dates... And these two guys... Back there. We'll bring you him up, and you up. And you up. You up. Right, so this is going to be our attacking force, basically, at the moment. It makes sense to swap for those guys, but their loyalty is shit. So I'm not sure what loyalty does, but I'm not super happy about a guy with no loyalty, though. Territory should turn attention to this one, basically. Do you wish to save? Yes, we do wish to save. Right, okay. So now we need to, again, we get a chance to enact another policy. Then we can come down here and look who is available. But I guess no one is. Right, that's fine. So let's seek advice. What does he think we should do? I don't think we should do either of those, really. Impose 5,000 supplies and raise the rice fields. Okay, let's get the 5,000 supplies just so you guys see what happens. We lose fame, basically, because we just took supplies from our people, right, for the war. So people were like, ugh, great. Now we can go, alright, next. This brings us to this field. Eventually we'll be able to do more than just the one action. But now we could invade this guy. Oops, no, don't, yeah, cancel that. Don't invade just yet. Because we've not got enough men, basically. We've not got enough men to take that out just yet, so this time, we'll just skip. Okay, and we got a bunch more troops. And all that, right. Now, we need to, look at our officer info. These guys have no troops, so we need to replenish these guys' troops. Now, this is the people, raise your fame. That's always a good one. Right, make their bonds deeper. We don't really want to make anyone's bonds deeper just yet. Acquire formation wings. No, basically, none of those interest me. So what I'm going to do... is go military, recruit troops... and go to this guy here and get that guy an extra bunch of troops. So he's like maxed out. Right, so now we're about even. Think we should go in? Cause we are just over the amount. So it'll probably be a pretty even. What is his facility? It's a hot spring. But attacking him right now might leave us a bit thin. Cause if this guy then chooses to attack, we'd be kind of fucked, basically. Let's leave it one more. So those guys have like had fights and shit, which is all fine. We don't really care about them. Now our officers. It's only this guy. Okay, so it's only this guy without anything. Not any men. But we probably should be able to go in. Wings. This is Rage of Fame. So we took Strife raising wisdom. I'm actually kind of interested in that. What is your two? Listen to people and acquire wings. Yeah, alright. Raise fame as well, which makes us just everyone a little bit happier. Okay, now it's time to do amazing. Okay, see, he's just gaining men the same amount that we're gaining men. So basically, we're just gonna have to attack. I feel like we're just gonna have to go in and just see what happens. Oh no, what have I done? Don't take that guy in. Remove. He's our fucking leader. We'll take in as many men as we can. And then we'll use this guy. We'll use our guy and our reinforcements as reinforcements. Just so that we've got extra things. But therefore he's reinforcements. And if he does come out onto the field, we'll just tell everybody to defend. Basically, that's my current plan. 9 minutes. Man, that is like right up all our supplies, isn't it? Screw it. We can like, once we've got this little corner, we can take our time and gain a few things. Evenly matched. Yeah, I was afraid of that. Alright. Let's see how this goes. I'm not super confident in this. Right then, let's give it our best shot, I guess. The first area shouldn't be too hard to get a hold of. I'm just worrying about once we get pretty deep in. Well, actually, we might be able to be pretty sneaky here. And cut some, a lot of time off. If my, theory is correct on the whole areas. No, horses, please. Why horses? Why? Why do they even exist? The worst troop in all of Dynasty Warriors, Samurai Warriors, whatever game you're playing, One Piece, Pirate Warriors, in any warrior game, horses are the worst. Right, here we go. Got some extra health. We don't really need it. But actually, well, I don't know. We probably could do it after those fucking horses. Are they more horses? Yeah, more enemy horses. Okay, so this is our territory, and people, they're attacking us, right? Now we could Oh, Lady Asaka. Okay. Well, you're kind of cute. Shame, not really gonna have any issues with this. Right, now, what we're gonna do is call our chestnut, call chestnut. So we're gonna go right into this area, and we're gonna take this base. So we're gonna tell all to defend. Right now, we're gonna tell all to defend. It'll just be me. Right, so if we can take this base, we should take everything, I believe. We may have to go into this mode, actually, though. Because basically, they're just, like, ridiculously strong otherwise. How did that... Although, we've almost got it. But there we go, and that took all of them. See, so that was like a massive, massive jump for us. Take the guy off the horse. And now we're gonna go through. We're gonna go through the area. Oh shit, hang on, let's get rid of those two. Yeah, all defend, all keep defending, so you guys are fighting those two. I ran right past you guys, I do apologize for that. Now we're gonna run right through their enemy main base and get the other area. Okay. Well, at least that's my plan. Let's try and charge. Can we charge? We can charge. Fantastic. Okay, so she's reappeared. Everyone's defending, everyone's pretty good. We will now run straight through the enemy camp to the opposite side. Ow, no, I don't want to jump off my horse. I want to run this way and take out this base. See how much, see how morale they are. I don't know if we're actually gonna be able to take this very comfortably. Anyway, this is gonna be a lot of hard work. Ow. Well, at least on the bright side, there's no like officers in this area. We would be pounding on the officers for ages. That was actually a fucking lot easier than what I was expecting. Okay, so now the main area is like completely full of wimps. We can take it over pretty nice and easy. Let's actually ignore these guys, because hopefully we'll capture them. If we don't kill them. If that is how it works. Right, we can go into our main mode and just hopefully wipe them off the fucking face of the earth. We didn't really use much of our time, did we? I feel like we wasted a lot of time there. We could have come in with a hell of a lot less supplies spent. Well, at least we won. So that's good. That's very, very good. Lieutenants. Beautiful. Right, good. So that's our area now. Priest of Fame. Clan, now do we employ? Seems happy to employ us. He also seems happy. Man, all these people are just like super happy just to fucking join us. Right, we will have this land Let's move you all in here for now. Hang on. By the way, what have I done? Select multiple. Let's drag them all back over here. What the? Ah, there we go. That's how you do it. Right, back here. And then over here, you can switch with this guy, because these guys are definitely our attacking force. Because look how many men they have. It's ridiculous. Now, that one can now go to that one, and you can go live with him. Then you guys can all sit in the new area. The new area. Right. Okay. Who the fuck is that? Unplaced officer? You can sit in here with the zero dudes. Right, done. Plague appears to have ended. Lovely. We lost a lot of men, I guess. Right. Okay, so now we can actually... Soon, well, not now, but soon we'll be able to change these guys and actually put better people suited for their things. Or is that now? That's actually exactly right now. So let's put this guy in charge over here. Along with this guy. Keep that there. That's a you. That's a you're actually pretty damn good. However, that will give us an increase. Now you guys. We don't want anything to change, we just want increases. I'll increase the loyalty. No real way we can increase anything else. Right, okay. We're good with that. Confirm our magistrates. For next year. Right, now obviously this is going to be our next target. Now we haven't got the supplies to go in. We haven't got the supplies to go anywhere near them, basically. Yeah. Okay. So let's have a look. We've not got the supplies, but we have got the troops. Like, fucking look at our troop strength. It's ridiculous. We can walk it right in there and just take everything we want. But we need more supplies first. So we're going to have to start looking at better ways to get supplies. So we can just like start moving up and hopefully kind of just take everything. Like, I'm not sure where their guy is. Probably here. If we come in here and go around, take out Tokugawa, take out her OG guy, and then we can just like keep pushing forward, basically. And we'll eventually take over all of Japan. But that's good. We will have a look at what these guys have to say next time. Thanks so much for watching. I'm not really sure how well this transfers to a show. So if you guys are enjoying this, we'll definitely do more. Let me know in the comments below. I'll see you next time for more. Bye-bye.